Yes, so welcome back. It's now time to dive straight into our conversation this morning. And our conversation will be around the recent development in Enugu State as it concerns the relationship between the cattle herders, the Miyetti Allah group, and the people of the state. But just about over 2 weeks ago, a reverend father was killed or gruesomely murdered in that state by suspected herdsmen, and these have sparked some reactions from the Catholic community as well as residents, indigenous of that state, that these have led to the Miyetti Allah coming to say, okay, we need to find out what exactly went down, we need to know who exactly did this. And to achieve this, they had decided that they would do a sensitization, rather go on a sensitization tour of the state for 2 days, in which the livestock market would all be shut down. Now, how effective this will be in rebuilding or rebuilding the trust between the people and these Fulani indigenes in the state, or rather Fulani settlements in this state, remains to be seen. We have in our legal studio Alistair Wilcox, who is a social commentator and a public analyst. Alistair, welcome to the program this morning.
Thank you for having me. It's only Silverbell that can bring me out of my house on a public holiday.
We appreciate.
A rainy Victoria Island.
We appreciate that, Alistair.
You think it's raining?
Yeah, rainy Victoria Island.
At what point did it start raining? By the time I came
in? As I was coming in, I mean, I had to start battling with the rain.
Well, so no August break, as we call it.
Well, showers of blessing.
Thank you for coming on the show, Lester.
Thank you very much for having me.
And we were sure that right after the show, you can go and continue with your holiday.
Yes. I don't mind the ram is being shared in the studio.
We'll be part of it.
Okay. We'll let our management know about that. Okay, let's dive into the issue, the issue of focus this morning. Enugu State.
Yes.
I don't know. There was sometime we heard that there was a report by some Fulani extracts that at one point in time, there was a huge settlement of the Fulanis in Enugu State, and that to some of them gave them the right to claim ownership of a certain settlement within that state. How true? Can you corroborate that story?
I'm not sure there was a right to settlement. I know for very well, because I travel Enugu Port Harcourt Road most often when I was in the east, even up till now. I know very well that there's a place, I can't remember the name. In fact, I was coming, I was thinking the name of that town. That town where you have the cattle market along the express, where you have the cattle market, very big expanse of land.
Yes.
Well, a lot of, in fact, most of the time when I pass there, I don't feel comfortable because of the debt that comes out of the place. But it's a very big cattle market along the express, that's between Enugu and Umuahia. I can't remember, but I think it's between the places of Enugu State, you know. So I can't remember the name of the place. So it has always been there for years. Each time I pass, I see the place. So when all this issue about Fulani, herdsmen and problem started in Enugu State, I couldn't comprehend it because I knew that these are people that have existed in that location, which is very big, for God knows how long, you know. So how did this whole thing now begin that every section of Enugu State, you now start hearing skirmishes of Fulani herdsmen and indigenes? Now, I remember also that in 2015 or 16 that there was a massacre of indigenes in one community in Soviet in Enugu State, and they said it was Fulani herdsmen. In fact, a lot of conspiracy theories went into that story. For me, when I heard of some of the things that were being said, which I mean, cannot be true, was the fact that the governor knew about the attack going to happen. He called on the president. I mean, that was the story that was said. He called on the president, and then the president said he should call on the GOC and all that. And he had about 4 hours. Now, you never forewarned the people that were in that place that they were coming to attack them for 4 hours. Enugu is not a very big state. In 2 hours, you can send truckload of even local vigilantes to go and protect the people, or to go and even evacuate, or to inform the people. But that, I never knew that happened. But remember this then, we keep hearing something that, oh, the president didn't do anything and all whatnot. So there has been that, since then, there has been that mistrust. Some true stories, some fabricated stories, some social media stories about what has been happening with Enugu State between herdsmen, and it cut across all the southeastern states between herdsmen and cattle rearers and the community. So it's for me it's worrisome because there is so much mistrust. Most of these stories are fabricated stories, and people are acting based on them, because majority of the stories that you keep here, sometimes rationality we can tell that can some of this be true, you know. But not to say, not to diminish the fact that there has been serious security issues, especially between herders and farmers, in terms of where herders have to destroy farmlands, go through farmlands, destroy farmlands, and all. What that's always been the case. But this recent development of the murder of a Catholic
priest,
as a matter of fact, three or four days after the incident, the culprits were caught and paraded, and it was discovered that they are cultist group within the church. They are members of that Catholic church that murdered the Reverend Father. Meanwhile, before then, the Catholic community, backed by other people, have staged a protest all over Enugu State, tagging the crime to Fulani herdsmen, the Fulani that killed the priest. Now, you see, the danger that we have put ourselves in is the fact that by the time we rush to judge situations, then we are creating more problems than solving.
All right, although I don't have, I'm not privy to that information.
Yes, yes, it's all over the place.
I'm not privy to it though. But you're referring to the Nimbo community of the Uzawan in local government.
Yes, them.
But now the Miyetti Allah group, they said the reason for the shutdown was to enable them embark on a sensitization tour of all livestock and perishable good markets and every Fulani settlement in Enugu State on August 14 and 15. That's tomorrow, Wednesday and Thursday 15th. Now, would you say that they are finally acting or finally doing what they ought to do? And if they had done this before now, it could have saved a lot of lives. No,
Miyetti Allah is not a security. It's not a security agency.
It's a group of people.
Yes, the unfortunate thing again is the fact that Miyetti Allah has been stigmatized with criminality. Miyetti Allah is a trade association, just like you have the National Road Safety Commission.
No, I haven't said that they are a security group.
I'm addressing the issues, because most often than none, when things happen or when issues are raised, they will say Miyetti Allah should have done this, should have done that. It's good that they are doing it now. As a matter, like I said, it's not their responsibility to detect crime. It's also their responsibility to check the activities of their members.
They are not detecting crime. They want to know their members.
Yes.
They have given some rules and regulations.
Yes.
If your family is not domiciled in Enugu State, yes, you cannot herd your cattle here.
No. Which of course is what it's supposed to be as a trade organization, as a trade group. Now, when you have stigmatized the people, you have brought them so low, in that even if a crime is not committed by them, you now say it is them. Now, are you encouraging them to do what they're supposed to do? You are marginalizing them. It's never too late. Like they have already, like they have chosen to do that now. It's never late. I'm not sure before that they've kept quiet, they've kept silent with all this that is happening. Because it is not with their own best of images. Their image is at stake at this point. Those who are genuinely, like I said, I know that particular cow, that particular settlement where they have always been, and I've never heard that there is a problem with that settlement. So, if there are criminal elements within their midst that does things wrong, I think they should feed them out. There's no against saying that carrying out a sensitization tour around Enugu State, trying to profile, trying to have a complete
records
and profiling of their members, is not a bad idea. You understand? But they shouldn't have gotten to this level before they do it. Yes, they should have done it quite a long ago. But that collaborative effort again between the community and them shouldn't have gotten to this level where the church will take it upon themselves to raise false alarm against them. I was very particular. When I saw that protest, I was very, very disturbed. Because a crime occurred, and then you have not gotten to the root of the crime. The next thing is for you to target to a particular set of people. I mean, that is completely wrong. And then after a while, when the perpetrators were arrested, were caught,
and paraded by the police. I didn't see the church either apologize or come back to do another protest to say, okay, we are sorry, we were wrong in the first instance. But rather, they will start saying that what the police did, you start hearing conspiracy theory again about it all.
Anyway, we are not holding brief for the church at the moment, but it's important that we state this here, that over time, there's been this huge level of mistrust of the Miyetti Allah Association all across Nigeria. And it's easy for them to be tagged. When, in as much as we are not saying that it's the right thing to be done, but it is easy because over time, there's been a high level of distrust and mistrust between them, about these people. So my question now is, do you see this whole move by the Miyetti Allah in Enugu State as a good move to probably achieving a better level of trust between both parties in the state?
I want to seriously wish and pray that the move by Miyetti Allah in Enugu State should create that level of trust. Because if you deliberately refuse to trust somebody out of their own deliberate
heart of wickedness against that person, or deliberate misconception of that person, no matter what that person does.
You see, there are sometimes, even in the family, if they are not, if somebody just decides to dislike you. So no matter how you be the best of presenter or best of anything, you will just be seen, it wouldn't budge. Now, you talked about Miyetti Allah being having issues. When did this Miyetti Allah issue come to the forefront, become the forefront? It's about 5 years ago. Before now, nobody heard about Miyetti Allah. Miyetti Allah has existed, I don't know how long, has existed. In fact, even when Miyetti Allah made former President Jonathan their patron, they collected him in regarded their patron. I don't think it raised any eyebrow. But in the last 5 years, since this current president become this president become president, the issue of Miyetti Allah become a press issue, and every crime, every old wound now surfaced up, and it now become Miyetti Allah. And the Miyetti Allah is now being tagged as a terrorist or as a criminal. In fact, some people even recommend that Miyetti Allah should be classified as a terrorist group. When even the crime that you are alleging they committed, there are no empirical evidences. Look, I'm a Christian, I'm a Southerner, I'm a Nigerian, I'm a Southerner. And if I see something going wrong in my country, I think I have the responsibility to speak out. And that's what I do everywhere. I don't care who it is for or who it's against, so long as I want to stand on the spot of nationality. This is a organization that have existed, we have lived side by side, we've had conflicts with them, we've had conflict between herders and farmers, never started today. I remember the worst one that happened in your state during that dream when late Blam Adeshina was the governor for your state. I remember when it happened. It was bloody. I remember when what happened, that happened in the Laro area of Ogun State, in the Laro area of Ogun State, during the time of Benga Daniel as governor. It was bloody. It has always happened. Because whenever there is struggle for resources, sometimes it can generate to scale. It has always happened.
All right, so.
But I'm coming, sir. So, but you see, all that time, we didn't have this massive campaign against them. We tolerated them. We didn't try to meet all the problems that were sitting in the board. We tolerated it, which is wrong.
And let's stay on the topic.
Yeah, right? This part of the topic.
Let's not go down.
No, sometimes we don't go down the memory lane. Because memory lane will help us to solve the problem better.
We're looking at the 14-man committee that the Miyetti Allah has set up to look into these martyrs, identify their members, and weeding out infiltrators. Now, do you think they should work hand in hand with the Enugu State government, or do you think they should do this all by themselves?
No. It has to be a collaborative effort. Because in any case, the security of the state still lies with the governor. He is the security of the state, the governor. And so whatever thing that is going to be done, even among people, the government should be actively involved. Because the alternative is to create more chaos. And chaos can lead to so many things. Because if Miyetti Allah choose to, if the cattle association or the group or the cattle rearers choose to leave, it's okay, we are tired of this place, we are this hostile environment, let's leave. What will happen? The only source of our protein, major source of our protein in this country is from cow. And we start to consume more cow even. Because we do more celebrations, we do everything. Nobody eats with one piece of meat, we eat with four, five.
And we talk for yourselves.
No, you. I know that you eat a lot of
meat. I eat fish.
No, I eat pomo. I eat the pomo.
I eat fish.
That's my own specialization.
Which is part of the cow.
But a lot of people, so I can do without it. But a lot of people who cannot. Certainly, no, let's be honest. We need it. But so if the supply becomes an endangered species and cannot do their business in the best of the environment and with cooperation of the people and with adequate security and with trust, then we are jeopardizing that element, that angle. So the government of Enugu State, the communities need to come together. Look, this profiling of Miyetti Allah as the perpetrators of all violence and crime in the country needs to change. Because as not only in Enugu State, everywhere there is crime, if it is going to be reported in the media and while reported, it must be linked to a headsman. If it cannot be linked to headsman, it will be in fact that news will be depressed. It will hit at a byline.
Wouldn't you think that the Miyetti Allah they have a lot of work to do in terms of image laundry across Nigeria?
I'm not their PR. I don't even know any member of among them. But sincerely speaking, I don't think they've kept. I don't even know why. It started like this, but at the same time, yes, they need a voice, and that is why the press should also give them voices. They need a voice to also air their own part, because if you consider most of the risk that the cattle business faces in the north, this issue of armed banditry and cattle rustling is not targeted against the Miyetti Allah group, because they are the owners. They are the ones that own the cattle and people come to see their cattle. So they are also endangered species. They also need some level of security and protection from the government, from everybody, because they too, by the nature of their business, they are endangered. And then they also need places where they want to feed their cattle, because they need to bring these cattle down for those who consume it, because they cannot consume it alone up north.
We don't rear cattle in the south.
And again, also, let us not forget, this cattle business is not only done by Fulanis. There are so many non-Fulanis that own cattle. But also give it to Fulanis,
because they are the ones that have the skills to rear cattle. So most often than not, we tag everything. We tag Miyetti Allah, a terrorist group, we tag everything. I'm not standing for Miyetti Allah, I don't know them. But I am only speaking from the side of rationality.
Right.
There are criminal elements in among them, yes. Which they, I think, they should dig deep right now. They should dig deep right now and fish out whatever criminal elements that could, and then profile their own members. Have a database, their locations, where they breed, and where the locations are. So that if there's a crime, and then form their own internal security arrangement groups to monitor themselves and to also monitor and protect the communities, help protect the communities where they are doing their business.
All right, Alistair, we were almost out of time, but let's talk about their results.
Yeah.
The Miyetti Allah Cattle Breeders Association says they would ban herdsmen whose families are not living in Southeast from grazing their cattle in the zone. Now, do you think this is going overboard, and do they have the constitutional powers to make this kind of a pronouncement?
No, they don't. they certainly do not, because you cannot restrict movement of people. It takes the government. They are not the government, and as I said, they cannot consider themselves into the government of Enugu State or government of any part of the country.
But it's an association that is recognized, in Nigeria.
Yes, yeah, an association just like saying the NURUTI should ban anybody from coming to in Lagos. Should ban anybody that is not living in Lagos from coming to operate his vehicle in Lagos or out of Lagos or out of anywhere. They are just a trade association. Now, it has to be a collaborative effort between themselves and the Enugu. So, you see, when people are coming to a state, especially these herders, they don't come in. It's not a secret thing. You know those who are coming in and from where they are coming. So it's not the state that we should decide. Do we need to admit more people? Where are the areas we have located for them to to breed. If anybody is coming in, does he need to go and register first with Miyetti Allah as recognized by the state? If that is the goal, yes.
Then the state should make a pronouncement.
You talked earlier about the need for Miyetti Allah to set up internal mechanism, internal security mechanism. And then one would also have thought that this, like Zika just mentioned, ensuring that any cattle herder, any herdsman, or any member, anybody who decides to be a member of the Miyetti Allah, should have some level of responsibility.
Yes.
That could make them liable. I mean, I'm sure that's more like an internal security measure that the association is trying to put in place, yes. Which I wouldn't think out of context.
No, it's not out of context, but the context of saying stopping people from coming to Enugu or stopping their fellow from coming. No, they cannot. The state has to decide if they have had enough. And because you cannot start fighting, you cannot start creating government as inside government. We are always created to do identify, okay, new people are coming. State government, are they allowed to come in? Okay, if you are coming, are you coming to register with us? So that you have a proper record. But you cannot say you could stop people. But I think they need a better structuring, both in Enugu, in Abia, in every part of the state, they need a proper structuring, even at national level, a proper update and proper sensitization of the public, of their members, so many things that they need to do so that this stigmatization, this profiling them as a criminal organization will start giving way to them. And the pressure also help. It's not every crime will talk to Fulani Hesman or to Miyetti Allah. Let us also help in the stigmatizing this pressure, this noble group that existed, that we existed hand-to-hand with every other person in this country, and let us have a better country.
All right, thank you so much, Alistair Wilcox, a public affairs commentator. Thanks for your time with us on the program. Talking about the Miyetti Allah group shutting down business in Enugu State tomorrow, Wednesday 14th, and on Thursday 15th of August 2019. We hope there won't be a serious economic implication to this shutdown, but I wish them the best of luck. We'll take a break at this point. When we come back, our next discussion is up next. Please stay with us.
You say something, you say no.